Another Ibn al-Harith used to spend his money to get information about other customs, to entertain people with that information. And he would hire female singers and entertainers. And what he would do with them, if he saw someone coming to learn the Quran and learn about Islam from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he would send them this female singer so she could sing for them and dance for them. Then he would tell them, this is better for you. Look at this enjoyment. Enjoy yourself. Have fun. Don't listen to what Muhammad is saying. Don't listen to the Quran. It's going to restrict you. You're not going to be able to enjoy and to have fun. And Allah revealed about him and those like him, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَشْتَرِي لَهُ الْحَدِيثِ. And from the people are those who buy لَهُ الْحَدِيثِ, the amusement of speech. Why do they buy it? لِيُضِلَّ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, to make people go astray from the path of Allah. And when we look into the story of another, it's just like those we see today who are spending their amwal, spending their money with so-called entertainment to make the people go away from the path of Allah, to distract the people from what is truly good and beneficial for them. The great Sahabi, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anh, was asked, what is the tafsir, what is the meaning of lahu al-hadith, the amusement of speech? He said, wallahi, it's the ghina. He said, by Allah, it is music. And he repeated this three times. Also, Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he said that lahu al-hadith, the amusement of hadith, it is music. The two most knowledgeable Sahaba, companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when it comes to the tafsir, the understanding of the Quran, both of them are giving us the same tafsir for lahu al-hadith. So they can mislead others from the path of Allah without knowledge. And then Allah says, وَيَتَّخِذَهَا هُزَوَى, and they take it as a mockery. They ridicule and they make fun of the Quran and of Islam. And this is what it leads to when you put a barrier between yourself and between your heart and between the kalam of Allah, between the Quran. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anh, he said that the love of music and the love of Quran cannot come together. They cannot be combined in the heart of the believer. If you love one, you lose the other.